Congratulations on season 3 of this show. This is a show that, when it first became a show, I doubted it could live up to the high standards of the movie Fargo. Then I doubted season 2 could live up to season 1. And now you're up against all these things, and you guys are just hitting it out of the park every week. Was this a show that you were familiar with when you took on season 3?
I was very familiar. I'd actually been talking to Noah Hawley, who's the genius showrunner behind the show, for a while, because we met about the first season, and I had those same reservations. I was like, why?
why mess with Fargo?
It's like my favorite movie. I've seen it more times than I've seen any other movie, so I was kind of terrified about it. And then it turned out I wasn't available anyway, and so that didn't materialize. And then season 2 came around, and we talked about trying to find a cameo for me, and that didn't work out. And so by the time he called about season 3, I was just like, yes, please.
And it was great. I mean, the part that eventually came around to you was one worth waiting for. How much did you know about this part before you signed on?
Nothing. I really did. As soon as he called, I just went, yeah. Like, he didn't even get a full sentence out. Yeah. I just went, yes, I will play
it. That puts you in a terrible negotiating
position.
Right,
I know. Yeah. It kind of does, right? I didn't really think that through. But I just knew. I mean, having seen the other 2 seasons, like, every single part is so good.
It's so good, but I should point out, because each season has sort of that sort of classic Frances McDormand, cop character. You are not that.
I'm not that. That's sort of being embodied by Carrie Coon's character.
It's fantastic as well.
So good on the show. So I knew she had already been cast, but I still kind of thought I would be playing maybe somebody like that, or maybe a nice housewife.
You're not a nice housewife.
No.
You're a real bad seed in this show.
A real bad seed.
But there's one of the things I love about Noah's writing is there's a great detail about you, which is you are an excellent bridge player.
Yeah.
Do you know how to play bridge in real life?
I took some lessons.
Because of this?
Because of this.
Gotcha.
And I was determined in the beginning to, like, really become an expert and be, like, super method, but I'm not smart enough is what
happened. How fast into bridge? I've never learned how to play bridge. How fast into it did you realize you couldn't?
Probably in the first 10 seconds.
Really?
Yeah. It went so far over my head.
So we have to give huge props to the elderly.
Yes.
We really do.
Yes. This is what, yes.
I mean, it's amazing.
It's incredible.
Because there's the scene where you play bridge in the show. It's instant nonsense to me.
Oh, it's gibberish.
Yeah.
I mean, it's so complicated and strategic and mathy, you know? There's so many numbers and things to memorize and
That's
think
good.
About.
That's good. I like it. There's old people keeping their brains sharp. That's it.
Absolutely.
Ewan McGregor plays brothers in this show. And so was it weird just basically having to act with Ewan as he played 2 different people?
Well, I mostly just had to act with him as one character, so
right.
That was helpful. He really was this character Ray for me all the time. But occasionally I would run into him when he was in makeup as this other character, Emmett. And even though he actually is in way less prosthetics in that character, he's much more just himself. He only wears a wig and colored contacts, whereas in Ray he's just in a fat suit, he's got prosthetics, he's this whole thing. But the main difference is in this other role, he wears brown colored contacts, and so it makes him look and feel like a completely different person.
Right.
Like, it really changes his entire...
Is it hard? Can you tell when you're acting with someone wearing colored contacts?
Now I know that I can, yeah.
Yeah.
You know? It's like, it really does, like, put... I mean, it worked out so well that he's wearing them for this character, because that's the more sort of character that people don't relate to as much.
Yes.
And they almost had him wear it for Ray, and it would have been... Such
awful.
A mistake,
yeah.
Because you want to love Ray, and it's so hard to kind of love someone when you've got, like, something in between, you know, like that.
I once, on Saturday Night Live, I never wore colored contacts in my life, and there was one time Lauren wanted me to wear them because he said, I feel like the person you're playing would not have blue eyes.
Really?
And it was Osama bin Laden.
You know, I can
I think
understand.
That was an argument where you're like, well, I don't know. So the episode that will have aired when this airs, which is fantastic, we were talking about backstage, you were out in the Alberta woods.
Oh, yeah.
And it looked freezing.
Mm-hmm.
And this was an episode with a lot of stunts and a lot of falling around. And you tweeted a photo of your leg and this bruise. Is that a painted-on bruise or
no,
the real thing?
That was real.
Wow.
Yeah. And it got worse. At a certain point, I couldn't post anything because I was like, "This people will really worry about my well-being at this point. I can't. Can't do anymore."
And with that cold, because you're sort of not dressed for the cold for that scene, what are you? Is there any tricks to the trade of how they keep you?
It's a lot of layers. It's a lot of, like, really attractive layers.
Oh yeah, you have a photo. Another photo you showed.
So
this is the attractive, alluring how you keep warm when you're.
It's really, I like like the booties. I think that's the sexiest part, that it goes all the way to the toes.
And how, basically, how long does that help until you're freezing in that, too?
Once it's soaked, you know, I actually had to walk through a freezing river while wearing this.
Nothing's built for rivers.
You're screwed. And then you have to stand by the heaters, and you steam. You literally watch your body steam, and you just wonder if you're going to light on fire in any given moment.
Well, thank you for putting yourself through all that. It is so worth it for how wonderful the show is. It's so great to have you back.
Thank
you. Congratulations. Mary Elizabeth Winstead.